The Movin Mavs program started in 1976 when Jim Hayes came here as a student from Tarrant County Community College. Coach Hayes, as a student, started wheelchair basketball, and then when he graduated, he actually was hired by the university to continue what he was doing in providing services for students with disabilities. UTA was one of the first programs in the country to begin providing especially sports and recreation programs for their students with disabilities here on campus.
We gained a seat on the President's Student Advisory Council, and we felt like that the best way to get their attention or to help them understand was take them on a tour in chairs. Let them see it from our viewpoint. Dr. Duke got in a chair. The first ramp he came to was in the old engineering building, and it was way too steep. I mean, no handrails, nothing. But Dr. Duke was a stubborn man. He tried it, and he flipped over backwards and tore his suit coat. He decided that day, though, that he would start working with his staff and with the administration to see what UTA could do to become more accessible.
He really saw the need for education in the lives of people with disabilities. Less than 30% of people with disabilities actually get a college degree. And really, that's the foundation of this program.
Our final story tonight first. UTA's wheelchair basketball team playing in Illinois tonight wins another NCAA title. That makes three in 3 years.
UTA was the first program in the United States to give scholarships for students with disabilities. UTA won 4 straight national championships. Other schools started having some ammunition to go back to their campus and say, look, if we're ever going to compete with UTA, we need to start offering scholarships. My son was born in 1986 with spina bifida. We were in Arkansas and there were no sport programs for him to participate in. So we started finding opportunities for him to participate in sports. As he got better and as some of my other athletes got better, we met Coach Hayes and he started recruiting some of our junior Rolling Razorback players. We loaded up a truck and came here to UTA, and I worked on a master's degree in curriculum instruction, great program here at UTA, and helped Coach Hayes for a little over a year. In spring of 2008, Coach Hayes passed away and I applied for the position. We have a really unique blend of players on our men's team. Because we've had players go on and be successful in wheelchair basketball at an international level, and some are even playing professional wheelchair basketball in Europe, that's brought the exposure of the program around the world.
I'm from Venezuela, born and raised. While I was driving my car, some car passed by shooting and they hit me in my spine.
I grew up in Cairo, Egypt. I was driving, someone was passing the road. I avoided hitting him, and one thing led to another, car crashed, had a spinal cord injury, had to have a surgery.
I was born with something called spina bifida, and that is just kind of like a defect in my spinal cord. I guess it's cliche, but there's always the why me question, but I mean, it's something that I learned to deal with and get over with.
So I moved to the US to do physical therapy. Everything was different, because it's not only moving to a different country, it's also moving to a different type of life that you need to get used to, and you need to relearn how to work your body. I didn't care about being in a wheelchair in a different country. I just wanted to get better and better and better.
I started realizing like all the stuff I could do on a wheelchair. I mean, you still think about it, but you don't care about it as much because you see it, but like all the different stuff you can do, like just in a different way.
When people come watch wheelchair basketball for the first time, when they leave and you ask them, well, what did you think? They immediately say, that was not what I expected.
I watched it for the first time and it was amazing. Like the speed these guys were going at, all the contact.
The game is aggressive. If you're not bumping chairs and if you're not fighting as hard as the next guy, you're just gonna get tossed aside.
So this is kind of our home for the Movin Mavs. This is kind of a little lounge area right here. A lot of students will come in and just hang out here before practice or after practice. This room is a disability research lab that we share with the kinesiology department. They come in here and they do like treadmill activities on the wheelchair treadmill. Coach Hayes actually won some of these awards in here for track He was a Paralympian. We've had several Paralympians come through the program. So this is a little bit about all of them really that make us who we are today and what we do today, and kind of remind the guys when they come in here that they're part of this legacy from the past into the future. We do a lot of camps for injured service veterans. And so our friends from the Army gave us this. We worked with them for Warrior Games and helped them win the wheelchair basketball in the Warrior Games 3 years in a row. We also use this area to work on all our chairs, some chairs over here that need to be worked on. So they'll come in, they use the grinder, we'll fix our wheels. We have a truing stand right here where we help true the wheels, fix the flats. Each of the guys had the option of getting their picture on their locker. And it's funny, we're here by Kyle's locker. Kyle was on ESPN today as the goalie for the USA National Sled Hockey team that won the World Championships just this weekend in Buffalo. So that's pretty cool. When we travel, we play on rec courts. When teams come here, they play on a full-size NCAA court. Regulation three-point line, regulation free throws. Everything's the same as NCAA wheelchair basketball. So this is where we spend 20 hours a week training and practicing.
Oh man, in the beginning of the season, I would have thought I'd be so excited to talk about this, but I'm not. It was really unforeseen that we lost in the semifinals. And to say that we didn't even make it to the championship round, even just to see what would happen, I mean, it would have been a good game. Like, I think we would have won if we made it, but we lost to a team that we hadn't lost to all year. That was the first time they beat us. We usually beat this team by like 30 points. And so just to think that we lost by 1 point is, I mean, it's a fun fact to look at, but then at the same time, it hurts. Like, it hurts.
That wasn't the result we were thinking we were gonna get going into the championship games, but to the credit of the guys that came back for the third place game and beat University of Missouri by 32 points. So they wanted to send the message that, hey, this isn't where we should have been. We're a better team than this. And hopefully it's going to get their attention and their focus going into next season. To me, the most rewarding part of being a part of this program is seeing these guys go across the stage and get their degrees and graduate and move on and have independent, successful lives.
Coach Garner is an awesome person. He's fun.
He cares about your family, how you doing school.
We're looking at it like 4 years of college. You want to get a championship and probably best days of our lives. He's looking further. Like, he's not looking at those 4 years. He's looking at the next 30 or 40 years, like, how are you gonna do after you leave here? It's like he's getting you ready.
He understands the disabled community better than some disabled people. I think he really connects to his players and to people in a very strong way.
When we go out and do appearances, and even when we go play basketball, we're playing for all the people with disabilities out there. You never know when that mom or dad with a little boy or a girl in a wheelchair, or that person down the street whose neighbor is in a wheelchair, can see us and say, hey, there's more out there for my kid or my neighbor or my cousin than we even knew about.
I enjoyed my time, I had fun, but I wasn't really doing anything like worthwhile. And I think that coming here, getting that chance to play wheelchair basketball like on that level, it's given me like some kind of, like something to look up to, something that I want to do for my future.
Wheelchair basketball is almost like a sport of its own, so it'll just kind of be nice just to get that recognition.
This sport should be treated like it is. It's a serious sport, it's a professional sport.
We don't just hop in our basketball chairs and start playing for fun. Like, a lot of people are really passionate about this sport.
Not being able to walk doesn't mean you're not an athlete anymore or you're a person that needs to be taken care of. I'm pretty sure some NBA athletes or some major league players have been through the most difficult stuff or probably as difficult problems as I've had. So I don't consider it a problem, it's just a change, and then you adjust and keep going with your life.